Bonjour!
Bonjour!
No.
Time for bladder check.
Check.
So, it's a show?
It's a lifestyle. It's a religion.
My emotions! My emotions!
I'm still French.
Ouais, c'est pas faux.
I'm a woman, Mary. I can be as contrary as I choose.
Non, moi je crois qu'il faut que vous arrêtiez d'essayer de dire des trucs.
Wait for me for a minute. I didn't take any break between episodes and I'm still recovering from the last one. Hello! Hi, I'm Laura. I'm gonna watch The Legend of Korra season 4 episode 3. As you just understood, I watched today's episodes 1 and 2. If you want to see my reaction videos about that, I'm gonna put all of the links into the I. The last episode was something, you know, the end of the last episode was something. The final line of the last episode was something. Something which can put me into that mood, into that state. Boo! Tuff is back, ladies and gentlemen. We knew it. We knew that she was gonna be back, like they talked about her during the season 3. I was already surprised that she was not back during the season 3. Like, why naming her like that to make her wait an entire season to have her, really? Why not? But still, why? So I knew that she was gonna be back. I was already wishing, expecting her to be right there, to have a reunion with Katara and Zuko, really. I have her during the episode 2, especially during an episode which was only about Korra, not at all, but why not? Like, you already did that with Zuko during the season 3, surprising us like that, so why not? And I saw it coming a little, you know, with that scene, we know that Tuff is hiding since a long time, so right there to have someone without really seeing her face and who is hiding under the swamp and all, I was like, okay, this is tough. So I'm glad, really. Tuff, I love you, you know how much. And your sassy remarks, I miss them so much. So I'm glad. I just thought about it. I loved your relationship with Zuko and also with Iroh. If you can be there during their reunion, because yes, they're gonna have a reunion, they have two. If you can be there during that reunion, oh, I'm sorry. Okay. Oh, yeah! That's it. Now I have a smile. But I have to say why I was not having a smile just some seconds ago. For that final line, for Tuff calling Korra Twinkle Toe, the nickname that she gave to Aang. Because for her, Korra is the Avatar, so Korra is her old friend Aang. No. Lost the connection with the past life. For me, they didn't disappear. For you and for the show, they did. So right there, Tuff, you think that you're talking with Aang when in fact he's not here and he's never gonna be there again. I'm not gonna cry again seeing that, seeing of that. This team Avatar is never gonna be back. Cool, really cool. Ah, you're with Tuff, that's great. Maybe she's gonna help you, I don't know. I can't see how she can help you with the situation, you know, with the Avatar State. The fact that you lose the connection with the Avatar State. Really, Korra, make an effort. You're losing the connection with all of the spirits that you are supposed to be connected with. The past lives and the Avatar State. It's your job, you know, and you're losing them. Can you stop? I prefer to be mad than sad. You know me now. If you are following me since a long time, you know what is happening right there. This Avatar State was fighting you, was attacking you. The symbolic of that, you know, that chain, the fact that she's trying each time to take you with that chain, and right there it was to take you with her into that metal thing, like the metal poison that Zaire put into you. Do you still have maybe some metal poison into you and that's why the Avatar State can't return into you, is fighting you? No, Katara, she would have felt it. Or maybe the Avatar State is infected and not you, Korra, anymore? Ah, maybe it's more something like that. But how can you heal the other state? And you know, I had that theory during the season 2, the fact that maybe, you know, after hearing Rava and Vatu's story, I thought that it would be logical that Rava at some point would leave the Avatar, because for me, the natural order is to have Rava and Vatu out, you know, good and bad out, light and dark out, you know. Okay, it's great to have the impression that the Avatar is keeping the light of the world, is protecting it, but it's not the natural order of things, so I thought of it. So now to have Rava, the Avatar state, out of Korra, it's not making me worried at all. I want, of course, for Korra to be okay, so to repair the situation, to heal. It's not gonna be like it was before that, you know, like, I don't know. And I don't know how Toph can help with that. I mean, she's an earthbender, so she can't meditate, she can't go into the spirit world. For me, rather, it's a spirit situation. So now that we have Toph, are we gonna have the reunion with Zuko and Katara during this episode? Everything can happen right now. And Toph, you need also to be reunited with your daughters. I think that an explanation moment scene is gonna happen right there, like, why did you disappear during all of this time? My theory for that is the fact that, you know, during all of these years when she was a cop, she had a lot of responsibilities, and okay, it was going well with her character because she's someone really who has strong principles and values, and while all of them, they were creating Republic City, they were trying to do things good, she was the one who could do it, in fact, to take the responsibility of security, you know, in Republic City. So it was not out of her character, in my opinion. But when she retired, and Lynn, she said that it was because of what Sue did, when she retired, maybe she escaped, you know, almost from this life, because she came back to herself, you know, to be free, to be independent, to be all alone, like we knew Toph like that during Avatar The Last Airbender. So maybe it was that. I can expect a lot of things, a lot of reunions right now. Maybe they're gonna surprise me and they're gonna create other emotional moments that I'm not suspecting right now. I think that I'm gonna love it, but I think also that it can make me emotional really quick. We'll see. And I know also that after filming this episode, I'm gonna edit them, you know, on the same day. So really, for me right there, it's an entire day of emotions, big emotions. Sometimes, you know, when I edit the videos, I'm like, you should film yourself just to show how emotional you can be, to see you that emotional on screen, but also to rewatch again that scene. I'm also losing a lot at myself when during the editing I saw myself being so emotional. I'm like, girl, really, your emotions are too high, you need to control yourself more. No, I've never controlled myself. I love that part of me, I learned to love that part of me, and even more for reaction videos, because I think that it's the best way to express them, in fact. Okay, I'm gonna stop this intro right now. Like usually, if you want to have my Patreon, on which you can have the episodes earlier, we have 4 episodes of Advance, and I'm putting extended or full reaction part for the last episode of the season 3 and for the first episode of the season 1, it was a full reaction part. It's also the best way to support me. If you can't come on Patreon, you have YouTube, you can subscribe, like, comment. Let's go for this episode. Am I ready for it? No, I don't know anymore. The first episode made me mad to see that the Earth Kingdom Basing Sea, it's not resolved, and even worse than that, we have to choose between a dictator and a stupid king. And the second episode made me sad. an happen during this third episode. Yeah! Let's go for it. Interim leader, I understand more your position. The coronation? Now?
It's the most dynamite 6-hour show you've ever seen in your life. Shouldn't you be getting ready to, I don't know, rule the whole nation?
Care about your nation and your people?
You're not worried about her handing power over to Prince Wu?
Yes.
When Kuvira started cleaning up the Earth Kingdom, she knew her position wasn't permanent. She gave me her word that she'd step down.
Did you call her, you know, just last days? I know it's supposed to be funny and all, but I can't.
The world needs me. Get over yourself. The world doesn't need you one bit. I worked my butt off busting criminals. But did that make crime disappear? Nope. It's that the names change, but the street stays the same.
So basically you're saying that everything I've ever accomplished has been pointless. I thought Beifong was grumpy.
I'm the original Beifong.
You are!
You're not gonna train me?
But I can't stand you being so bad and your butt kicked all the time.
Oi, oi! You're
here to work.
And Vespa's also here.
Oh!
I see you have replaced me with a new girlfriend. Well done.
Not,
Vera, she's kind of my boss.
Boss, girlfriend, same thing.
Right, I must have turned purple when Kuvira made him pardon me of my alleged crime.
Julie, one day I want you to be free.
Upstanding is right!
You must be sorry that you didn't come and help us. I don't know if I'd call marching all over the Earth Kingdom, forcing people to bow to Kuvira, doing good. I'm just glad that she'll be stepping down after tomorrow.
Are we sure of that?
I hope I'm not out of order saying this. You're pretty easy on the eyes for a military type.
Make him stop.
Moved you into a very nice junior suite.
Something you should know about me. I always get what I want.
Things were looted after the Queen was removed from office. So the coronation may not have some of the usual items. There's no crown? How can you have a coronation without a crown?
For that, I agree.
Actually, the king. We still have one of the royal jewels we can pin on you. No acrobat bell ringers, no horn blowing announcery guy. It will be a very simple, intimate, elegant ceremony. A wonderful day for your
I prefer that, me. I'm really an arm on that.
You don't. Tell me what you did wrong.
Well, I was thinking that you were
right. Exactly.
You were thinking.
You were thinking. Go again. Pathetic. Of all the avatars I've worked with, you're by far the worst.
It's just the second one.
What made you want to drop out and disconnect from the rest of the world?
I'm more connected to the world than you've ever been. Vines, they run all over the world. I can
see
Berlin, Zhao Fu, and Republic City.
I am touched by the love of my devoted countrymen, who have worked so hard to restore their beloved leader to the throne. For your service to the realm, I would like to present you with the Kiyoshi Medal of Freedom.
And if you don't mind, I'd like to say a few words.
Why not?
It was the pathetic rule of kings and queens that caused the Earth Kingdom to descend into such incredible disarray. And there's no way I will allow it to slip back into the Dark Ages.
But don't you understand?
I'd like to make an announcement to the world. The Earth Kingdom is no more. Created a new Earth Empire, and I will continue to lead it into the future myself, bringing about a new era of prosperity for my people.
My people. Bolin!
Anyone who crosses our borders or stands in our way will be crushed.
I was really surprised.
Oh, Bolin. My sweet child.
Believe in the work that we've done for the people of the Earth Empire, right, Bolin?
I do, but
then stick with me.
For the Earth Kingdom, the Earth people, not for you.
Idiot king will serve them and neglect the people. Just not sure about this whole empire thing.
Yes.
Aggressive.
How about an Earth Republic?
Believe me, conflict is the last thing I want.
Leia.
Will you help me make history, Bolin?
Please say no.
I'll stand by you.
Ah, oh, I love your loyalty, but right there.
When the Queen fell and everyone was asking you to help keep the Earth Kingdom from falling apart, all you wanted to do was hide in Zhao Fu and and let others deal with the consequences.
That's I'm gonna put the blame on her.
You have to step down. I stepped up. I provide stability and equality. You won't accept their hand-picked dictator.
What you saying that?
You're just another tyrant.
Yes!
Don't pretend that people put you where you are. I know what happens to cities who don't want to hand over control to you. Then you know what's coming for Zalfur.
Okay, I just have to go on. Move forward, take decisive action. Let's go shopping.
I'm desperate with this kid.
Kubira is helping out all the poor people.
Oh, you're gonna be against each other.
This is for the best. I mean, Kubira is basically just like Korra. She might seem hard to deal just because she's so passionate and believes in what she's doing. It seems like she's just a dictator who's taking the Earth Kingdom by force.
Thank you, Mako.
So you think your new best friend in there would be a better leader than Kubira?
Neither.
Come on, Mako, I'm making a difference out there.
Is this really the only option?
Insulting another man's suite?
That's what
I know what would cheer you up. A visit to Little Ba Sing Se fashion mall.
Alors, Ba Sing Se, you want to go shopping when you should
I never realized how much I miss tormenting the Avatar. And you me in my prime. I would have destroyed you.
I just don't understand why I can't get back in the groove. Probably carrying around that metal doesn't help.
What metal?
The little bits of metal poison stuck in your body.
I was right!
You can get it out for me, right?
Who do you think you're talking to?
It's destiny. Look where we are, Mako. The royal palace. The throne!
It's not...
You're losing it. This is the worst day of my life! You really want to be the king? I mean, Kuvira might be a power-crazed dictator, but at least she spent the last few years working hard to make the Earth Kingdom somewhat better. Do you think you're the kind of person you want as your king? What have you ever done for your people?
Thank you, Michael.
That was out of line.
No.
No, you're right. I guess I'm just a joke who got what he deserved.
Can you change?
Let's get you out of here and back to someplace safe.
Carry me?
No.
Okay. I see a window of up. Go!
Clearly, you want to keep the metal in there.
Ah.
Why would I want poison inside me?
I don't know.
As a reminder?
Maybe so you have an excuse not to go back to being the Avatar. Have to worry about getting hurt again.
That's ridiculous.
She's got the fight.
You want it out, you can bend it out. I can't deal with all your issues for you.
Wait. Oh, you're rough, tough.
From now on, developing this technology is your number one priority.
This is going to change everything.
Overreach. Why do I have trouble to trust you? No. I'm less desperate. Come on, I have reasons to be less desperate. We have some reasons to have hope. We have the confirmation that inside of Korra right now there is still metal, and that's why she's blocked. Her bindings are blocked because of that. And it's also because of a psychological reason that Sue maybe didn't find it the first time, or at least that right there Toph can't get it out. You're haunted by the year what he told you and all of that. I really think so, and I think that also Toph was right, the fact that you don't want to go back to be hurt again, but also to take your responsibility of the Avatar again, because you think that you failed them, because it's rough. Okay. That's a reason to have hope. She's gonna work on herself, she's gonna find a way to have this metal out. Because of that, she's gonna merge again with the Avatar State. Okay. And the other reason to have hope, it's that moment of truth, you know, between Mako and Prince Wu. Really, during all of the episodes, I was like, yes, he's fun, yes, he's making funny jokes and all funny lines, all of this thing about the ceremony and what he wanted, like, that was fun, I can see it, but I couldn't lose or, you know, be excited, enjoying that moment, because each time I was like, we don't want that to be the new king. If I don't want to have this dictator with Kuvira on the throne, you know, ruling that nation, I have to be okay with that stupid guy being the king. No, so really I couldn't lose, you know, enjoy this moment. So to have this moment of truth between Mako and Prince Hu, it's giving me reason to have hope, to wish for him to change, to learn more about his nation, to care about it and about your people. Maybe rather you were just a kid and no one never told you stuff like that, and you wanted to be the king just because all of your family was, and you were counting on your ministers like all of the kings and queens before you did. Like, maybe they never showed you another example, and that's why you just wanted that. And you can change, you can change. I have to hope that, you know. Okay, why not, why not? And Mako, you can be the good person to teach him all of that about the Earth Kingdom, about what he can do or not. Like, he has strong principles and values, Mako, and he knows also everything about being all alone, being lost, and fighting for what is right, or protecting your loved ones. Like, he's really the contrary of a prince. He's not someone with privileges. He had to fight for everything that he had, so he can be the good person to teach that kind of stuff to Prince Hu. Now that even more, him is not the king, so he's no one anymore, and they don't like him. At least they are not fans of him. They are cheering for Kuvira. Yes, she's a fucking dictator. In appearance, she can do good stuff, you know, and she wants what is best for the Earth Kingdom, but it's just a question of appearance. In fact, we can see it into her eyes and into her attitude and all. She wants power. At least right there, she wanted to keep it, you know, for sure. Her plan with Varric, what is it? Oh, Varric. Again, you're gonna be on the bad side of the Force. You're really a character that I love a lot, but that I can't trust, that I can't believe into. Like, each time I'm like, what are you gonna do next, which is gonna be an issue for us? And rather, it's his invention with the train. He put that into the train motor, you know, like, I don't know what it can be. Julie, at some point, girl, I hope that you're gonna be free from Varric. And at the same time, I'm like, why, since all of this time, she's following him? Is it someone from your family? Is she doing that for money? I'm really wondering. Julie, I really hope that at some point you're gonna be free, okay, far away from Varric. That speech, you know, during the coronation. She knew that she could do it, that no one could be against her during that moment, that people would cheer, because in appearance she's good, you know. What can she do? How can they have the proof that what she's doing is wrong? Because okay, Mako, he said everything that I told you in intros and reviews about the fact that she's just creating a dictator right there, she's just another tyrant. But for people to see it, really, you know, during the first episode, the governor, he knows what she did, how she convinced him, and the fact that it was wrong, and the fact that she conquered that state by fear, by threatening them in a way, by manipulating them, by taking advantage of their weakness, of the fact that they were desperate. But people into that state, they didn't see that, and they just saw that the governor made a deal with someone who is responsible, you know, into the Earth Kingdom, was that responsibility. And because of her, they had food and stuff like that. Then they just saw the good things of that contract and all. Like, they can't know, they can't see what is wrong with what she's doing. Only, you know, the leaders, only the politics who are dealing with her can see it. Poor, that's bad. And Cora with Toph. The two of them fighting. Toph, she always had sassy remarks and she was always, you know, like that with our guys. And we had several occasions into the Avatar The Last Airbender to see, you know, the anger crisis that she can have and stuff like that. But right now, how she was talking with Korra, she was more than rough, like she pushed her so much, so hard. But at the same time, I missed her sassy remarks, so I was glad to have them, you know. Of course, she felt the metal, which is still inside you. Katara didn't feel it during the time, you know, all of these years that she tried to help Korra. None of the metal benders, you know, Su, Lin, that you were with, felt it. I mean, she went out of Republic City really quick after the ceremony, you know, Jinora's ceremony. Maybe they didn't have the time to feel it. No, it's not a question of time. Maybe it's too deep, you know, for them to feel it, and only Toph, the first metal bender, can see it, feel it. So good! The fact that she can feel everything that she could do, Korra. Of course. So right there into the swamp, you're feeling more connected to the world. That's what you said. It's not really an explanation of why you chose to hide right there. Like, you're saying that hiding yourself right there, it's not that bad, you know? And that's why you're giving that reason about the fact that you're connected to the world by being into the swamp. But you know, it's not the reason why. It's one of the consequences, one of the good consequences. I want more explanations than that. And of course, I want a reunion with your daughters, with Zuko, with Katara, with maybe Spirit Iroh when he's gonna meet Zuko. I thought about it, you know, I don't know why during the episode, that reunion between Zuko and Spirit Iroh. 3 years now that Zuko knows that Spirit Iroh exists. The reunion already happened? Like, we're gonna have them already hanging up together and we didn't see it? I really hope that it's not the case. For once, I would be okay with something not explained, you know, why Zuko didn't do it during these 3 years and he waited for that moment to go meet Iroh, Spirit Iroh. Okay, it's okay for me. For once, I would be like, okay. So yes, I want this reunion. With our old guys, I think that it's gonna be cool. With your daughters, I think that it's gonna be rough. If you're into that kind of mood, tough right now, how are you gonna be with your daughters, with your grandkids? Okay, I'm gonna stop this review right now. It was cool, these three episodes together today, as an introduction, you know, for this season 4, this final season. Really, the main issue of this season, it's gonna be the Earth Kingdom, restoring peace in Earth Kingdom, and also in Basing Se. But you know, it's weird because right now we don't have one enemy like who wants to rule the world, who wants to destroy things, to destroy the Avatar. Like, the enemy right there, it's Kuvira, but it's more a political situation, so you can't resolve it by fighting her just like that. Like, she has an entire army and she has people cheering for her. The situation is really more complex and really different than all of what we had before in Avatar The Last Airbender and also The Legend of Korra. To have that main issue for the last season, it's interesting. As much as to have balance as the main world, you know, for that season, and the fact that since 3 seasons, enemies of Korra are accusing her to bring unbalance into the world, because having the Avatar is bringing unbalance into the world according to them. And the fact that I had that thought, you know, during the season 2, that maybe having Rava inside of the Avatar, it's not the natural order, you know. I'm wondering about the end of this season. We'll see. Okay, so it's all for you and for me for today. So it's all for me for now. So bye for now. Bye.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me you built a time machine?
Right.